Hi, my name is Ben Hodge, and today I'm going to be critiquing Elite Dangerous. Elite Dangerous is an open-world, classless MMORPG set in the distant future, where the player is given command of a spaceship and set loose in the Milky Way galaxy. First and foremost, this game is a space simulator and generally a slow game. Released in December of 2014, this game is pretty new on the market but already has a huge following. It's actually a sequel to a 20-year-old game called Frontier First Encounters. There is no story to Elite Dangerous. Instead, Frontier Developments, the developing studio, has opted for a player-driven experience. The three main criteria I'll be covering are galaxy, playability, and graphics. So this is an open galaxy game as opposed to an open world game. It features 400 billion star systems, meaning that every star in the Milky Way is mapped and modeled for the player to go explore. The Milky Way is massive. Elite offers players almost unlimited freedom. As the player gets deeper into space, the ride becomes somewhat of an issue. Sometimes it may feel like you really didn't just jump 100 light years because the scenery looks just like the star you just came from. A big part of any game covers the playability of the game. Elite offers an excellent flight model with responsive controls. It also keeps true to its roots with a customizable HUD, similar to the HUD from Frontier First Encounters. Elite offers compatibility with most head tracking devices like Oculus Rift and TrackIR, giving players an added sense of immersion. Players are given the freedom to do whatever they want and are not locked into a specific role. Players can be traders, pirates, bounty hunters, miners, or even explorers. Each role has a ship they would prefer. For example, traders would enjoy flying the Type 9 because of its giant cargo hold. Some pirates may enjoy flying the Viper because of its speed and firepower. From my experience, mining is the easiest but most time-consuming way to make money, making it one of the main occupations players do. Visually, Elite is beautiful. Any of the smaller rough edges are immediately outshined by the beauty of the stars and planets. They even modeled solar flares, so there's no lack of detail in these distant stars. Stations come in a few different varieties, from orbiting platforms to weird giant decahedrons. The ships you can fly around are pretty unique in their design, keeping true to the original architecture from 20 years ago. There are some graphical glitches that I've encountered, like not having paint render on my ships and weapon models glitching out. These are patchable and minor flaws. The sound design of this game is spectacular, to say the least. The bass of the explosions, the beeps of your targeting system, and even your engine sound extremely satisfying. Each ship makes a different engine sound, so there's some variety. It's somewhat difficult to start out. The starting funds are close to inadequate, and there's no real in-game tutorial explaining ways to make money. Luckily, some fans have made tutorials and posted them on YouTube. This game is amazing in many aspects, being graphically stunning, with spectacular audio, intense combat, engaging in-game economy, seemingly limitless galaxy, and of course, the opportunity to fly around in space.